We have flashbacks of the original fairy tale in the film, but the idea of the whole thing is that what happened to Hansel and Gretel after they killed that first witch. And the truth is that they became these vengeful witch hunters. And that's the rest of the film, is what they did.
I know, I've not counted.
A true witch hunter doesn't keep count. Yeah. I mean, it's just another witch.
That's right.
Yeah.
They are a duo. They need each other. They are true siblings in that. I mean, they're a team. They complement each other as well. I mean, they're very different. They both have this pain inside them and this sort of emptiness, but they cover it up well. And Gretel is definitely the more reserved one. She's a little quieter, a little bit more sarcastic. Hansel's more outgoing, I would say.
The great need for each other is because they're very, very alone on the planet. And, you know, we're talking about witches in 3D, man. Let's not get too deep on it.
Yes.
I was on this movie for a very long time until we could find the right Gretel. Because it was really important to Tommy and myself, everybody, that there was... first of all, the girl had to look good with a gun in her hand. She had to be, not everybody does. It looks like they could be physical. And that was even a big issue. But the more importantly, and then having a connection. We got lucky. Mm. She's easy to get along with. I'm a pain in the ass. I don't know, it just kind of worked out. But it was really important for us to connect and then apply. And that was the only thing we could grab onto as actors, is our relationship. You know, they all look for fresh blood all the time. Not literal blood, but like, you know, new eyes and, you know.
And Tommy, I mean, Tommy especially, he's fearless. He doesn't really have the constraints of making a Hollywood movie. Maybe it's because he's Norwegian, I don't know. And so he brings his experience from what he likes, and he's maybe not so experienced in Hollywood. So that's fresh, it's new, it's exciting.
There's tremendous talent all over this planet. And so it's no wonder that they're grabbing them up.
And Tommy's doing so well now. I mean, he's like a huge star in Norway, doing some really great stuff there, and lots of exciting things happening for him here in Hollywood.
Yeah.
So I'm really proud of him because this was an idea in his head when he was at film school in Australia years ago, and now it's real. And I think it's very, very surreal for him. Very collaborative, and I can imagine that it's hard. It can be intimidating for a director, a young director, to direct experienced actors. And we had, from Jeremy to Famke to Peter Stormare. You know, there's some really experienced actors. But he was kind of like straight in their first day, giving good notes, specific. And he has this great vision and sick mind. Loves violence, loves gore, blood and guts, and you know.
But a very boyish way, not like a really... gross,
no, but in
way,
a fun way.
In a very fun kind of boyish way.
We had a great stunt team, really great choreographers, done some fantastic movies, and I had to prepare because this is my first big action role, so I wasn't used to this kind of stuff. So I had like a month's boot camp kind of thing, which was great. Learning how to fight and do all this stuff, and then Jeremy arrived, and then we sort of the fights were pretty well planned, actually, like the main ones, so we could like prepare for them in advance and stuff, so that when we were on set, it was just like we knew what we were doing. But then some of them was, you know, Tommy would get excited and go, hey, how about we just fight here? And so some of it was pretty off the cuff as well, which was good because it was impulsive. But a huge part of the film was that, for both of us, you know, all this action. It was great.
I don't know if you're ever ready, brother. Yeah, I think getting complacent is when you can get really injured. So I worked just as hard on this as I did any other movie. Just a different style of getting beat up, I suppose.
We both got progressively more and more like damaged as the shoot went on.
Yeah.
We get up in the makeup chair in the morning, we're like, oh!
Yeah. Well, they had also cut out a lot of us getting our ass handed to us even more, because then it kind of verged on slapstick. They're like, wait, we want our heroes to be heroes. But so it's striking that balance of like, you know, how much do we lose?
Even though it is fun to get beat up. I mean, I love all that, like getting